Mary's worry over bringing a child into this harsh world would not prevent John from making bad jokes. He would say, "The baby does not seem at all worried," which was exactly what helped her keep calm. Contraptions that bring misery and infinite obscurity lay scattered, a public exhibition to all those who cross the King of Thieves. Thank you.
Thank you.
Many of the thieves were once merchants simply looking to make a living. Sheila's ring drew Ben's attention. The same ring that Sheila had always said belonged to her firstborn. This man was their son? Ben could not stop staring into Joey's eyes, the eyes that he had gotten from Sheila. When Joey informed his father of the many years since his mother's passing, Ben's heart felt cold. In that single moment, with the single gulp he drank, the memory of all the years with her passed through his mind. Regret became his companion then. It was not the warmth of the drink, but his son's touch that brought him out of the coldness within. Sheila was dead, but their son was here. And this was the future. A future they had to build now, together. Alongside the other Bergsons to clear a road to that future. Linda felt a deep sorrow when she saw that her tree, the tree her father had planted the day she was born, had withered and died. Though when she looked upon her grandma, her sadness lessened. Margaret was always a glimmer of light in the darkest of hours. Joey and Mark had not known each other for long, but as happens with some young men their age, a friendly rivalry was already taking shape.